Hey guys, it's Clint and Shell.
Hi guys.
Today is Friday. We're making gumbo, and she's gonna start. I did all my vegetable cutting yesterday, and we roasted the turkeys, two turkeys, and it kind of sounds like Shell and I, two turkeys. And then I cut the sausage this morning while I was trying to get stuff around. Today I'm making a belly bin. I am playing on something Shell did, and a sliding belly bin. But of course, I wanted to do fabric part of it, so I went ahead and did a little bit off camera. My iron's in the kitchen, and because we got so much stuff on the table right now, there's not tons of room. So I did take my interfacing and I put sticky crap on it, and because I wanted to make it firm enough, and I was worried about if I just did a ribbon, it wouldn't be very firm. So and I can explain why in a second, why I want it to be firm. Because it's an interactive one, I didn't want it to be a flimsy piece since it's a belly band. So I have something new. This is totally different for me. And like I said, the sliding belly band is Shell, was one that Shell was doing. And I kind of changed it up and made it my own. So I have this. This is a lid for a canning jar, a small mouth. We don't really use small mouths, and so we thought, well, we're going to do it that way. And then, this is a Shabby Dabby Doodah design team. And I had Shell, I had the lines going up. Let me... Oh, I need to mark this somehow, because I really don't want, because I have my lines here right now, and I'm have to be able to see them. And I won't see them once I put the sticky crap on the fabric. For those of you who don't know, sticky crap is Wonder Under or Heat and Bond. I actually used Heat and Bond on this. I found a scrap piece I had that was, I was able to do the ribbon and the fabric. That way I didn't have to cut any. So I have another piece I'm going to have to find. It's right here somewhere. I just had it a minute ago. I actually have some in here. I keep my scraps and stuff in my drawer. In my table, that way I can kind of use them as needed.
Yeah.
She said use them as needed, right? Yeah, that way I don't have to cut for my bolts, I can just cut for my scraps. So, here's the green. This was the inside of the cover. And, of course, this was the outside cover. And I wanted to match the ribbon to the inside cover, the color of green. So, we were able to find that. And now I'm going to put sticky crap on this. And I'm going to try to put it on this. It's kind of a... I don't know how it's going to work, because for one I did sand it. Sorry. I sanded it and roughed it up. I was hoping that would give it a tooth to hold the fabric. If it doesn't work, I will use her Fabri-Tac. She says I have to put it on there really thin. So I'm going to try this first. So I'm going to pause the video, put my sticky crap on this. And I have an idea for the fabric, so I need to go get it also. So I will be back in a few minutes. I hit my chair again, guys, or my camera. There we go. Didn't work. Ow, that hurt. And little Bubba, he is a gnar. Little Wilbur, and he bit my nose. Mama's got him. So that didn't work. So what I did is I went ahead and ironed the Tina's Digital on this. Made sure it was big enough. And so I have this. I'm going to do it, I think, in stages. Is this unscrew or is it just pop up? Oh, it does unscrew. Well, I'll be darned. I'm going to try to do it. She told me to make it thin, is what she told me. There's my lovely wife.
Yes, thin. Well, especially just where the
paper is.
Where the fabric is, because it'll seep through the fabric if you're not
careful. Right. Yeah, she's so she's decorating. And I, huh? Yeah, it's a I think I told you, but it's a tag team video, so I'm gonna have her decorate it, and I'm doing this part. She cut the paper out for me. It's a little bit easier for her to do. I've been having a hard time getting my hands lately. I've been really super sore and stiff. So I've been kind of struggling cutting stuff. I don't know if it's the weather. I know it's, sure, it's arthritis, but so I used a red tie or whatever it was. So now, like I said, she cut this out, and you can't really see it with the shiny. I've got an up and down line that's in the center, and then I have one because this is an up and down. So actually, yeah, up and down. So it would be like this, slide up and down. So I want to make sure my it's right, of course. Okay. And then she's going to do lace on the, so I'm going to go ahead, she's going to cover the ring, I think, with lace. She's, like I said, she's decorating and I'm doing this part, so, oh man, boy, she worked on ink blenders yesterday, and I had a few that she had to fill for me. To squeeze. They make, it's a, I call it, it's a wood super glue, and that's what I used. These, all the three have very, really deep cracks in them, and I put the super glue in, just a little bit in the cracks to keep it from cracking any further, and that's what she did yesterday for me. So, which was so sweet of her, I sure did appreciate it. And I burned my finger that I cut with the saw. I burned it yesterday when I was doing a blank, an ink blender, and it actually burned the skin and ripped the skin off at the very end of my scar. So it is really tender. And it's hard to put a band-aid on it because it sticks to the nail. I think that looking pretty neat, guys. I'm going to move you just this way a little bit. I lowered it. It was just so high. And I just thought, Sorry I went ahead and started the process without showing it to you guys. You guys know how I use the sticky crap, and I really didn't want to have to mess with having the iron on the table when it was just a little tiny bit of stuff. So that's the reason why I did that. Oh, grab my snot rag here. I don't want that getting on my good cutting mat. Did I do that? I think it's going to be kind of neat when it's done, guys. So. Dang. Okay. And since she's going to do fabric or lace, I'm not too concerned with completely. So I'm going to grab my scissors, and I could, you know, bend it over like so. I just don't think I want to do that. I think that's going to be too much trouble, and with her covering it with lace. And anyway, you know, it's kind of nice to know what the slider is made out of. I had other ideas, but they would work. I ended up cutting some plastic from a milk bottle to make the disc. I was going to make three of those, but they were just a little too tiny, and I figured it might be best just to do it this way. So I'm planning, I'm actually planning on a cover with this, using this technique, but it is a, has more to it, I guess I should say. Okay, so now, this is part of the milk carton right here. And I got her, what do you call that big yellow thing? This thing. That. Whatever that is. I got it. And let's see here. Let me grab her pencil again. Gotta find the lead for my. I have one just like this that she keeps stealing, so I bought her this one for Christmas. Not anymore, you don't. So we know that it's gonna be right there. I see it right here. There we go. Just to, and the other one's straight down, so I see. Huh? Wow. So, this is part of the milk bottle that I cut. If you remember, on her, she used paper, is what she told me. But this is too heavy, I think, for paper. So, I got her thingamabobber right here. And I practiced with it, and it's going to work. So, let's see, did I do that one? So, a minute. Okay, yeah, here's the, okay, there, and right here. Okay, there. Oh, that will work. Okay, so, let me grab my pen. I think that will work a little bit better. It's my heat erase pen. So what I have to do is here. So here's the mark right there. And I'm going to go right there with it. And then right here with it. Like so. And then this one is right here. Okay. So right now we're using two different eyelets. One will be bigger and the other one's the smaller one. And I did practice this so I could make sure it was fine to cut out. So I'm going to line up that, the whole thing, bobber, on my hole right there. Okay. And there's for one eyelet. That's for the smaller one. Put it on the bigger one. And like I said, the one spot right here, the dot right there, that's meant for the big one. So I'm going to put my dot right here. No. See, I messed that up because when I did my thing, it wasn't straight. Okay, hold on. Punched my hole in the wrong spot since it was all messed up, of course, guys. But that's okay, because I got another plan. So, this is a center finder. Like so. I'm going to put a little bit right there. And that way, that ain't right. Dang it. Clinton Dean, pay attention to what you're doing. I need it straight up and down, so. That should be right there. This is where it needs to be, right there. And then right here. So I put it right here. It should be about right. Yeah, I think that will work. It's not perfect, but you know, in life, nothing's perfect. So let me do my big holes first. So I got it set up. One right there. And one right here. Still not right. Okay. That will work. Still not straight. It's just aggravating. Should have been right there, but we'll see. So, yeah, I'm not doing very good, hon. No, it's already messed up. You want to look at it? I can watch that for a second. Yeah. Okay, I'll be right back. So she said, that's fine, go with it. And you know, whatever Mom has to say, that's what I'm going to do. Okay, here's the back. So, see if I can do it without. Okay. Let me. One right here. Right there. Okay. Let's see if this is. Oh. The big hole again. Okay, so let me put the eyelet here, and then we'll go from there. And you know, you live and learn in this. You know, it just But my other ideas is different. Some kind of. So that's these. Is that what it is? Okay. How's that gonna? That don't fit in the hole. The pop rivets, are they the one that's in? Oh, forget it. I got the really huge ones. So, let me. Whoa, I don't need that many. How's the gumbo coming? Wow. Well, truthfully, it's almost your time because. Okay. Yeah, because I'll need to start cooking it. Okay. Fine. Huh? You can. Yeah, I'm just doing the rivets right now. Or the... Yeah, that. Oh, it goes this way, doesn't it? Okay. So that's what it's going to look in back. Ah, dang it. It's so hard to hold. I cannot get my hands to work lately. Ah, Jiminy Christmas. Yeah, it's the gumbo's probably got at least 4 hours of cooking time after the roux. Okay. You know, it isn't horrible. These are my old fabric scissors. I'm going to use them as paper scissors since I don't really have any. So, trim off my excess plastic like so. So then, boy, trying to do anything is. I don't know.
Hi guys, it's me. And Clint, just kidding.
Hello, everybody!
Okay, so Clint was getting a little bit stressed. I want to show you guys why. It's really tight. And he's like, I'm just going to have to start all over. But I told him, get something and kind of pry it up. Remember like we did on the envelopes? And kind of stretch it out. Worked just fine. So, just trying to see what I need to do because I am the decorator. One thing I need to do is get rid of some stuff. I did run outside and got more stuff, and I told him next time we're going to have to do this inside or out there because I brought out way too much stuff. So, no, ma'am. Go see your daddy. Daddy, I need you to entertain Gracie.
Sure, Grace. Come on. You don't need your help. Come on.
So you did put the washable pan or whatever on this?
Yeah, so I need to heat it real quick.
Yeah, are you ready for that?
Yeah.
Okay, that way you can turn off the thing. So I hope you guys are doing well. It is Friday here as well as when you're seeing this video. I tell ya, my neck was just really bothering me last week. I do have an appointment to talk to someone about our medical stuff, and I'm hoping we can get in and see a doctor about my neck. So I like this. What do you guys think? Is it kind of something you would do, or do you have to see it finished? Sorry, he's in there. Stirring the gumbo. We're doing tag team on the video and on the gumbo. and I have to wait for him. So, he said there was two holes on the bottom, so I'm going to have to use those, and I already have an idea, so no biggie. And, yeah, we're just going to decorate it. Sorry. What else do I have to tell you guys? Oh, it rained last night. In fact, when I woke up this morning, there was rain. So, that was nice. Like I said, I just ran out to the shed, to the studio, and felt so, smelled just so fresh.
Oh my gosh.
Out there. No,
oh, the rain.
The rain. Thank you, dear. Okay, so we're going to figure this out here. Just want to make sure everything's glued down first, you know. Okay. That's so funny, though. He was stressing. He's like, what am I going to do? So just let me take care of it. Don't stress the little things, huh, guys? Nora, I'm so glad you reminded me to do the friendship video.
I'm going to do a gallon of...
journal. Okay. The friendship journal, because I was thinking that I need to do that, and maybe I can work on it like at least one day a week. That way I can still do my design team and still make sure and make journals. So maybe we'll call it like Friendship Friday or something. I don't know. Okay, so is that all glued down pretty well? I think it is. Yep. Not bad. Okay, so I do need two eyelets down here, so I think I'm going to use these green ones. Daddy, I need you to come entertain Arctic.
I'm going on. I'm doing the bra.
Well, come entertain him when you're done.
Sorry. I'm trying to get it all in there.
Let's see. Let's do these two green ones. Now, if I decided to, I wouldn't even have to, you know, he's like, oh no, you're going to have to cover up that one, or put an eyelid in that one. But I'm going to put lace on it, so really I wouldn't have to. And I'm going to look at it and just kind of see what I want to do. Do I want to, and, you know, are they going to be off? Because two would be really cute. But, like, one's right in the center and one isn't. But, no, I think it'll work. Like you said, it's a little crooked, but I think that's going to work well for me. Okay. So, that's what we're going to go for. That's okay. He's just starting to walk around. He's walking around, getting a little too close to me. So, we're going to use the little ones. You're going to turn it twice. Baba, for reals. Here's Arctic. Mr. Artie James. I know some of you guys who love the kitties are going to be thrilled to see him. There he is. There he is. And Gracie's behind him doing stuff she shouldn't be doing. Trying to keep his face in video. Little stinker. There's a bubba. Daddy's going to want to love on you in a minute. So funny, he's been going into our bedroom. Like, he'll run in and I can't catch him. But I know, you know, I'm like, oh yeah, he's in there. And then, like, 3 minutes later, he's crying at the door. So I'm glad that he's telling us, hey, I don't like it in here. Yeah. He likes fingers and toes. What are you doing, Bubba?
Diza Bubba. Dita Bubba.
Clint's still working on his gumbo. He has to add some broth because it was starting to stick, so. Dita boy. Mama's little arty dude. And if you don't like seeing the cats, then just fast forward. Because they are here for us. This is their house. Except usually I make videos in the studio anymore because of this. But we have those that love to see the babies, and those that aren't particular. Half a cup. Sorry, he's just jabbering. Yes, he is. Why don't you go see Daddy?
That. Lynn, what are you doing?
It's Arctic.
Oh, Artie.
Call him again.
Arctic, what are you doing, Bubba?
Go see Daddy. I think he's the prettiest one we have, though. He's a really pretty boy. Go see Daddy, Bubba.
Artie.
Oh, he hears ya.
Where are?
Go see what Daddy's got for ya. He might have something for ya. Keep calling him.
Artie.
Come on. Oh, he's thinking about it. He's thinking about it. Keep calling him.
Here, Art. Artie. Here, Artie. What are you doing, bud?
Here he comes. Yeah, that's one reason I'm took it all outside. But yeah, I think I'll do the friendship thing, Nora. I think that's a good idea. So I need to squish these two. One and two. Just keep them in place. I think that's going to be really nice. So, what else I brought in? I think I'm done with this. This thingamajiggy. But man, it's harder. Definitely harder now that the cats always need loving. Okay, so we got this, so we're able to slide it. We may have to stretch it a little bit more. Go see your daddy, honey. Just go. Go see Daddy. And see what size I need. One thing I've misplaced is my jump ring pliers. Yeah, I'm going to try these itty-bitty ones. I just need two of them. And my wire, which he is now sitting on. It's definitely harder. So I thought I would put some wire on here like this and hang wire, since you know you can always kind of be creative with a mistake. I really wish I had those pliers. I know they're red handled. Gotta get my stuff organized in the house, in the shed. Okay, we'll see if we can get this wire in here. Not wire, but you know. That one's across the room. I need to sweep anyways. Oh, jeez. I'm afraid it's going to. Yeah, that's one of my goals this weekend is to, not the greatest, but I'm okay.
What's wrong,
honey? Oh, I have to put these things in the jump ring, and it's always hard.
Oh, darn it.
Maybe I can put this first. I don't know.
Gracie, come here.
Is that even going to open that much?
Come on, Artie.
Oh, thank you.
No problem.
Let me see. Maybe the bigger ones. I'm talking on video.
Oh, well, there's nothing after you.
There we go. Maybe. Maybe.
Yeah, it's an instrument call.
Oh, wow. Well, that's what it usually is, isn't it?
Maybe a little lower, but yeah. That's
one I think is going to be easier, though. Okay.
Do you think it's going to work for you?
Eventually. Except when I get irritated at it.
Got it covered, baby.
Yeah, I lost a jump ring somewhere. think I got this one. Let's try it and see. There we go. So I am going to put this little guy on here. Make sure I turn it the right way. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that'll work. And then we'll put another one on here. But first, hon, where's your butterfly?
Right there.
Here it is. Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Does that go with that?
I think this is going to have a little one on it. Yeah. So let's try this again. Slide this on, make sure it's going to be the right way. And then we have to put on the other one, huh? Okay, we got this, guys. Right? This is very fiddly, but it's just these jump rings. I have, they're like doubled or tripled or whatever. Do what? Oh. I know you guys feel what I'm doing. Oh man, I thought I had it. There we go. Honey, come get Artie.
Okay. Artie, come here. Come here, Art.
Did you put Worcestershire in there?
No. Come on, Artie. Come on.
Okay, so I'm going to slide this on now. Like this. Because I want it to make sure it lays right. Otherwise, it's a big mess. Okay. And then we're going to slide this here. I think we might have it. Harder to doing it on video because you can't put it like right up into your face. Let me move this back just a little. That way it's opened a little bit more. Okay, let's try that again. Okay. There we go. What do you guys think? That's kind of fun. And if he hadn't have done that, then I would have never ever thought of that.
Oh, that screw up in you?
Yeah.
Oh, I like it.
And because this was kind of screwed up too, it still ended up being in the center.
Huh.
By my thing, so it worked out perfectly.
Oh, okay.
So, now what we're going to do again, I'm just going to kind of... And since he used that milk bottle, I think you could even heat it maybe.
Yeah.
Kind of stretch it a little bit if
I was
needed.
That. Yeah, that's what you do.
But he was like, what do I do? I'm giving up.
Well, I was fixing to start over.
Yeah, he was. And I was like, no, I can fix that. Do you still have your iron on?
Could.
Let me go stretch this. We're just going to heat it up, and then I'm just going to stretch it just a little bit. I don't want it too loose, so we just want it to be enough, you know, for to go up and down. So I'll be right back. Okay, let's try it. There we go. Look. So I just kind of heated it up. It did kind of bubble up, but I think that's fine. Look at that. Isn't that going to be beautiful on a page? Okay.
So
we got that. Now I'm thinking about the lace.
I did
bring in the lace. Do you know where it is?
I was actually going to ask you.
It's probably in here.
Lace? Okay, actually.
Oh, here it is. Not sure which one, but I thought I'd look at it and see. I didn't bring that in. I mean, I don't think it needs lace per se, but if it does, I think it needs it smaller. Just to decorate. I don't know. What do you guys think?
Well,
I think I'm gonna leave it. I like it. What if we just put like a ribbon or something on it?
Yeah. That would look good, wouldn't it, babe?
Maybe. Maybe so. Just a little tiny bow.
Oh yeah, that's perfect. Mr. Arctic.
I think that's cute. Let's do that.
I like that.
I want to try your new fancy ones.
Yeah.
Ooh, it's got like
butter. Aren't they nice?
But can I use them for paper?
I'm gonna ring them in.
I like it like that. That's cute. Oh, there's hair now. Stinkers. And I did bring in the journal. See what I mean? I had to bring in tons of stuff, and that did not make me happy. And we'll just put this little guy right here on top, like that.
That is so cool, huh?
And then you can pull it down or up, however you want to. So, let me show you. Grab the papers. Okay. So, and we would just put this in one of these books. I'm trying to find like some of the thickest paper. This one isn't really, but look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
Let's see. Oh, wow. What do you guys think?
If you want it, you can slide it up there, whatever you want to.
I think I had a pretty good idea.
I think you did too. I think it's really cool. And like I said, you know, whenever you make mistakes, and you guys know this, that is more opportunity for something more creative.
Right.
And, you know, I wouldn't have thought of this. I did think of putting the butterfly just hanging, but I like the butterfly on the chain. I think that's really cute. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys liked this. Let us know what you think in the comments below. Be sure and hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up, and we will see you guys in the next video. See you soon. Love you. Bye.
Bye, guys. Thanks for visiting. Cut zing.